New details tonight in a story you saw first on 7. The city of Albuquerque fires another shot in its collective bargaining battle with the unions. The administration has yanked permission that allowed employees to handle some union business on city time and in city buildings. Action 7 News reporter Will Carr has details.
And what has become a war between the city and the unions, part of the battleground, just got axed.
We've probably spent about $10,000 to $15,000 fixing it up, painting, tiling, doors, just fixing up everything to make it a functional office. In a professional office.
Joey Segala and the other members of the Albuquerque Police Officers Association have worked at this office in the bottom of APD for 6 years, all on the taxpayers' dime.
We think that the union should basically be doing things on their own time and on their own dime.
That's why the city just sent this memo, which states union employees cannot use any city equipment, property, or facilities for union activities.
And we think that if the taxpayer's paying them to be city employees performing those functions, that's what they should be doing with their taxpayer salary, not doing union business.
That means union members cannot use city cell phones, laptops, or office space.
But at the end of the day, it's city property. They get to dictate whether we stay or go. And we were given 30 days to go ahead and vacate the premises, and we will.
Segala says regardless, police officers will continue to serve taxpayers to the best of their abilities. That's what the city wants, just without having to shell out cash for the perks provided by taxpayers.
But what we're trying to do is basically right the ship that for several years caused this collusiveness and a potential for corruption.
In Albuquerque, Will Carr, KOAT Action 7 News.
Both city and union leaders say they're still in the process of renegotiating union contracts, which expire.